Before you toss the last 20 grams of your filament roll, print these 8 things instead. Because if you're anything like me, you've got a shameful collection of half-empty spools sitting around. Every roll ends with 10 to 20 grams left. Not enough for a proper print, but too much for my conscience to put in the bin. Instead, turn them into useful consumables for the workshop. First, I wanted to get a baseline for what the end of a roll actually gives you. So I measured out a few typical leftovers, and on average, I had somewhere between 10 and 20 grams left per spool. Not much, but definitely enough to make something useful. Packers, I use them constantly. Leveling, spacing, wedging, pretending I'm doing precision work. The usual. To get the most out of them, I designed a combination packer with 4 built-in features. A standard packer with a centre holes for screws, a utility blade holder for instant scraping, a plastic scraper edge and 5mm increment markings along the side for quick offset measurements. I made 10 different sizes from 10mm down to 1mm. Each clearly labelled so you can grab the right one instantly. The plastic scraper is great for delicate surfaces, but the utility blade upgrade is the real winner. Two small screws into one of the thicker packers turns it into a sharp metal scraper in seconds. Flip it over, add a bit of pressure, and it becomes a surprisingly effective cutting tool, perfect for quick cleanup jobs. And of course, it wouldn't be this channel without a French Cleat mount. So I whipped up a simple holder to keep all the packers tidy and easy to grab. Stirring, always a chore. I'm forever hunting for a bit of scrap wood, or worse, I end up using a screwdriver and then regretting it when I have to clean it. So I designed a better solution, a stirring stick that fits directly into a drill chuck. Because if you're not over-engineering simple tasks, are you even a maker? Technically, you can wash it and reuse it, but we both know you won't. Naturally, there's a holder for these too, so you always have a batch ready. If you, like me, you are constantly tearing cardboard off boxes for quick epoxy mixing, this next one will help you. I designed a small 3D printed mixing pad with a snap-off mixer paddle. Clean, simple, and way more reliable than a ripped-off box flap. It's the perfect size for small batch mixes, and with a little dispenser holder, you can keep a stack ready to use without sacrificing all your packaging. Zip ties. Essential, but wasteful. I'm always having to cut and refit when connecting extraction hoses or cable bundles, so I designed a reusable printed version. It uses a twist lock mechanism so you can fasten, release, and reuse them endlessly. I printed several sizes, each adjustable down to the tiniest loops. And yes, they have their own hanger so you can grab the perfect size on the fly. Funnels are another workshop frustration. Hard to clean, impossible to dry inside, and sometimes you definitely don't want cross-contamination, like chainsaw oil meeting your brake fluid. Maybe it could work? So I printed a set of small stackable disposable funnels. They print without supports, use around 8 grams of filament, and store neatly in a small holder. Pull one, use it, bin it, job done. One of my worst habits is using the tops of spray cans as mixing pots. It works, but over time can clog the nozzles or make a mess of where I keep them. So I made a lightweight disposable mixing pot using spiral mode in the slicer. They're thin, flexible, waterproof, and only use around 5 grams of filament. Although, yes, extremely easy to knock over. A simple holder keeps them upright. and a French cleat mount keeps both pots and holders together and easy to reach. Simple lollipop style stirrers, one flat end, one curved end, perfect for getting into awkward corners. Cheap, handy, and a great use of scrap filament. And yes, another little holder. Finally, painter's cones. Because nothing tests your patience like flipping a freshly painted piece and realizing you've just ruined both sides. These tiny prongs lift the work just enough to let you paint both sides without tears. They get covered in paint quickly, so having a stack is a lifesaver. Perfect way to use those final grams of filament. So what do you think? Are these the best uses for leftover filament? I think they're definitely better than throwing it away. If not, let me know what you would add to the list. Want more simple prints that actually make the workshop better? Check out my other projects and subscribe so you don't miss the next one.